The Jack Benny Program, presented by Lucky Strike.
Be happy, go lucky, be happy, go lucky, strike, be happy, go lucky, strike today.
Now I sell luckies to the fans, yes, that's the smoke to get. They've mildness and a richer taste in one great cigarette.
I am the pitcher for the team. They cheer my every act. The stands are like a lucky strike, so firm and fully packed.
Be happy, go lucky. Be happy, go lucky strike. Be happy, go lucky. Go lucky strike today.
Enjoy your cigarette. Enjoy a truly fine tobacco that combines both perfect mildness and rich taste in one great cigarette, Lucky Strike. For only fine tobacco gives you both real mildness and rich taste. And LSMFT, Lucky Strike means fine tobacco. So friends, be happy, go lucky. Try a carton of Lucky Strike.
Be happy, go lucky. Be happy, go lucky strike. Be happy, go lucky. Go lucky strike
Strike program starring Jack Benny with Mary Livingston, Phil Harris, Rochester, Dennis Day, and yours truly, Don Wilson. Ladies and gentlemen, just a few days ago, Jack Benny asked the gang over to his house to listen to the World Series. So let's go back. It's morning, and Rochester is preparing Jack's bath.
Oh, boss! Boss!
What is it, Rochester?
You can come in and take your bath. I've got your tub filled.
In a minute.
Until he gets here, I better add a little more soap and keep blowing through this straw. Mr. Benny likes a lot of bubbles. Look at those bubbles. Once I blew some big ones and he did a dance for me. I better check the temperature again.
Good morning, Rochester.
Your bath is ready for you, boss. Take off your robe and step in.
No, I've decided not to use the tub anymore. You know, I read a book by Bernard McFadden, and he said if you want to stay healthy, you've got to have good circulation. And the best way to get it is to jump out of bed and step into a cold shower.
Right out of a warm bed into a cold shower?
Look, if it's good enough for Bernard McFadden, it's good enough for me.
But, boss, he's younger than you are.
No, he just looks it. He's got a lot of hair. You know? Now, come on, Rochester. Open that shower door and turn on the cold water.
Yes, sir.
Let it run a while. I want to get it good and cold.
It ought to be cold enough now.
I guess you're right. Well, here goes.
Ooh, ooh.
Ooh, ooh. Oh, this is wonderful. Woo! There's nothing like standing in a cold shower.
Yeah, but I dare you to put down that umbrella.
Are you crazy? You have to do these things gradually. Now, hand me the soap.
Here you are, boss.
Thanks. Now, hold the umbrella while I scrub my back.
Yes, sir.
Ah, this is a light. Rochester, why do you keep moving the umbrella?
It's either you or me, and I've got my clothes on.
Get out of the shower. I want help, not company.
Yes, sir.
Well, I guess I've had enough. Ah, that was good. Hand me a towel, Rochester.
Yes, sir, here you are.
Thanks. Now go down to the kitchen and... Rochester, this towel is marked hers.
That's the one you borrowed from Mrs. Ronald Coleman.
Oh, well, give me the one marked his.
He came and got his.
Oh, well, hand me one of my own. And Rochester, get out my slippers.
The ones with the pom-poms on them?
No, they have no backs, and I keep losing my arch support. I'll pick out my own clothes. You go down to the kitchen and make some coffee while I get dressed.
Yes, sir. I ought to clean this house more often. Look at that dust on the piano. And somebody wrote his name in it. Kenny Baker. We haven't seen him in 10 years. Well, I'll clean it after I... Hello, Polly.
Hello,
hello. Well, I'd better dust the piano before I fix breakfast. Be happy, go lucky, be happy, go lucky, side.
Look at me. Beep, boop, beep, boop, beep.
You better learn the words, Polly. Coming! Oh, hello, Miss Livingston. Come on in.
Hello, Rochester. Mr. Benny home?
He's getting dressed. He'll be down in a minute. You know, Miss Livingston, he started a new health fad by taking a cold shower this morning.
Oh, him and his health fads. A couple of years ago, he wanted to improve his eyesight, so for months he ate nothing but carrots.
Did it help his eyes?
No, but his ears grew 2 inches. Then he tried to get the lead at Harvey. Oh, hello, Jack.
What's up, Doc? I heard what you said, Mary. You can stop making things up. How's your cold?
Oh, I'm fine now, Jack. And thanks for sending that doctor over. He was awfully cute.
The doctor? He was?
Yeah. And I guess I wasn't as sick as I thought I was.
Why?
He took my temperature, took my pulse, and took me to Ciro's.
That's funny. Me, he takes to Cedars of Lebanon. Did you have a good time at Ciro's?
Yeah, but it's kind of funny going out with a doctor. They've always got their minds on business.
What do you mean?
I told him my steak was too rare, so he put a tourniquet on it.
Hey, that's good. I bet your mother sent you that one, didn't she? Say, Mary, the gang will be here pretty soon. We're going to listen to the World Series. You want a cup of coffee?
No, thanks. Say, Jack, who do you think will win the series?
Oh, Philadelphia's a cinch to win.
Philadelphia?
Certainly. How can they lose with players like Eddie Wakes, Andy Semenik, Richie Ashburn, and Phil Rizzuto?
Rizzuto's with the Yankees.
Oh, yes. I meant to say Charles Ezard.
That's Ezard Charles, and he's a fighter.
Well, maybe I did get a little mixed up. I haven't read the papers lately.
You haven't read a paper since you stopped delivering them.
Look, Mary, go in the kitchen and help Rochester make the coffee.
Okay.
I'll get it. Must be some of the gang.
Hello, Mr. Benny.
Oh, hello, Dennis. Come on in. As soon as the rest of the gang gets here, we'll listen to the... Dennis? Dennis? Why is your arm in a sling?
It's my father's fault.
Your father's fault?
Yeah, my mother got so mad at my father, she picked me up and threw me at him.
Then why is it your father's fault?
He ducked and I went right through the window.
Dennis, I wish you'd stop
oh,
making
Jack,
up...
Oh, Jack, if the game starts at 1 o'clock in New York, it should be on here.
Oh, hello, Mary.
Oh, hello, Dennis. Jack, the game should be on, and if you... Dennis?
Mary, don't ask him.
But, Jack, I want to know what happened to him. Dennis, what's wrong with your arm?
Nothing.
Nothing? You told me you went through a window.
Well, that's how I hurt my leg.
Your leg?
Then why'd you put your arm in the sling?
When I put my leg in it, I can't walk.
You see, Mary? You see, you wouldn't listen to me, would you? You wouldn't listen to me, would you? Now, look, Dennis. I want to ask you one simple question.
Uh-huh.
I'm silly, but I'm going to ask it. I have no business to ask it. Look, you're wearing a sling, and there's nothing wrong with your arm. That I can understand. But why is the sling black?
Notre Dame lost.
And for that, you're wearing a black sling?
Pat O'Brien killed himself.
He did not! Now, look, kid, before the gang gets here, let's hear the song you're going to do on the show.
Yes, sir. Hold my sling.
Hold it yourself.
Magic spell you cast. This is La Vian Road. When you kiss me, heaven sighs, and though I close my eyes, I see La Vian Road. When you press me to your heart, I'm in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. And when you speak, angels sing from above. Everyday words seem to turn into love songs. Give your heart and soul to me, and life will always be La Vian Road. When you press me to your heart, I'm in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. And when you speak, angels sing from above. Every day words seem to turn.
Very good, Dennis. Very good. Gee, I wish I could sing like you do.
What?
I said that I wish I could sing like you do.
Copying, copying, always copying.
Huh?
First you wanted to dress like Phil.
Look, Dennis.
Now you want to sing like me.
Dennis.
You already walk like Mary.
Only when I'm wearing my pom-pom slipper. Now, let's not have any more of... Hey, maybe that's the rest of the gang. I'll get it. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some Luckies and Cracker Jack.
Remley's outside and he's flat on his back.
Well, leave him out there. Come on in, Phil.
Hiya, Jackson. Hello, kid.
Hello, Phil.
Well, Phil, the game will be on pretty soon.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Jackson, but I can't stay. I got to go to a wedding. Sammy, my drummer's getting married.
Sammy? Sammy, your drummer? You mean Moon Glow? Sammy's getting married?
Yep, he's going to marry the little girl who used to play harp in my band.
Gee, imagine Sammy getting married. I didn't know they were serious. I knew he went out with her once.
That's what did it. When he brought her home, her father was standing on the front porch with a clarinet, and Sammy thought it was a shotgun.
Well, that's a logical mistake.
Anyway, Jackson, even though I can't stay to hear the game, our bet's still on.
It's on, it's on.
How much is the bet, Jack?
Oh, it isn't money.
What?
That's right, Liv. Jack has Philadelphia, I have the Yankees, and the winner gets to kiss Betty Grable.
What about the loser?
He holds Harry James.
Yeah.
Well, if Jack wins, who's going to hold Betty Grable?
Mary, another crack like that, and May is going to have company.
Get it, kid?
Huh? Hey, Jackson, speak about the World Series. You want to hear a funny coincidence?
Coincidence?
Yeah.
In my living room, there's a picture of a little gray-haired old lady sitting in a rocking chair. And I just found out her son plays on the Philadelphia ball team.
Really, Phil? Who is she?
Sisler's mother. Oh, Harris, you may not be pitching, but you threw that one by the old man.
Phil, Yogi Berra wouldn't have swung on that one.
Well, look, Jackson, I gotta run along. See you later. So long.
So long, so long.
All right, Remley, we're leaving. Get up, will you, please? Let's get some action. Let's get the... Come on, Remley.
What a guy. You know, Mary, Phil thinks he's smart because he was appointed dog catcher of Encino. I wouldn't appoint him ambassador to Moscow. It's the last time I'll buy a joke from John L. Lewis.
Jack.
What? I ad-libbed that one in the middle there. I had it ad-libbed for about 12 minutes. I had it written in there already. I wrote it in with pencil, so you wouldn't know that. I'm an ad-libbing fool, you know.
Jack.
What?
Why don't you stop picking on Phil? I think he's pretty smart.
Smart?
Yeah, he's a lot smarter than you are.
Smarter than me? Dennis, name me one smart thing that Phil Harris ever did.
He didn't ask me why my arm is in a sling.
Dennis, that isn't being smart. That's self-defense. Anybody who's foolish enough to ask you would... Come in! Oh, hello, Don.
Hello, Jack. Hi, kids.
Hello, Don.
Hope I haven't missed too much of the ball game.
No, no, Don. We still have a few minutes. The game doesn't start till 10 o'clock.
Well, look, I've got a quarter to 11.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Don. How can a man of your age and dignity wear a Mickey Mouse wristwatch?
You gave it to me for Christmas.
Oh, did that go to you? Yeah, I meant it for Phil. He can't tell time, so I thought he'd enjoy the pictures.
Jack, if you want to hear the game, you better turn on the radio.
Yeah, come on, let's go in the den.
Oh, by the way, Mary, you all over your cold?
Yes, Don, thank you.
Well, I hope being off the program last week hasn't set you back too much financially.
No, no, Don, I pay insurance premiums every week, and any time I'm sick and stay off the show, I collect half salary.
Gee, I'd like to get that kind of insurance.
Jack, here's another customer for you.
Don, you'll find an application on the piano there. Well, sit down, everybody. I'm going to put on the radio now. Here goes the old ball game.
Ladies, does your husband talk in his sleep? He does? Well, send for our little stool pigeon tape recorder. It will soon pay for itself.
I thought this was a station.
Well, hurry, Jack. We don't want to miss any of the game.
I'm trying. I'm trying. Isn't that awful? I can't get the station here.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we bring you another in our series of speakers to discuss the world situation. Tonight, we have the Russian delegate, Jacob Malik.
Я очень рад быть здесь. Погода здесь была очень хорошая. Дни были теплые, солнечные, но ночи были довольно прохладные. Конечно, вчера стоял туман. Да получше. Да, в общем, какая разница? Какая разница?
How do you like that? He walked out on himself. Why can't I get the ball game? I've been tuning in to different...
Now we're on the wind.
Oh, her again. I don't want that.
And now for our next contestant. Your name, sir?
Twombly. Joe Twombly.
Now, Mr. Twombly, your question is, in what year did the Pilgrims land on Plymouth Rock?
1776?
Oh, I'm sorry. You answered that question wrong. But for your trouble, my sponsors want you to have a 13-cubic-foot refrigerator, a 16-inch Admiral television, a grand piano, a 40-foot yacht, and $50,000 in cash. Better luck next time.
Gee, it's a shame. It's a shame he didn't answer it right. Now, where is that ball game?
And here we are in the last half of the second inning of a very exciting game.
That's it, that's it.
Woodling is up at bat. There are two strikes against him, and here comes the pitch. It's a long fly, a high fly. It's going up. High, high, high.
Oh, for heaven's sake, in my excitement, I turned the dial. I'll try to get it again.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, coming up to the plate is Rizzuto. Woodling is on first base. Woodling is trying to worry the pitcher. He's dancing off the base. He's dancing back again. He's dancing off again. And now he's dancing back. As announced earlier, the coach on first base is Arthur Murray.
Arthur Murray? I thought he was with Brooklyn.
This is a tense moment. Rizzuto calls for time. Steps out of the batter's box. Takes his bat and hits his shoe to knock the dirt out of his spike. DiMaggio is now batting. Rizzuto broke his ankle.
Oh, that's a shame.
However, we want you fans to know that even though Rizzuto will be out of the game with a broken ankle, he will collect half salary thanks to an insurance policy he took out in Beverly Hills.
Jack, do you know Rizzuto?
No, he was visiting the Colemans. I happen to be over there.
While I was giving you that little sidelight, DiMaggio took two strikes. Here comes the pitch. He swings and misses. It's strike three. The crowd is going wild. And here comes the next pitch. He swings and misses for strike four.
Strike four?
And here comes the next pitch. He fans the air for strike five.
Five?
As you know, DiMaggio is the umpire's nephew. And here comes the next pitch.
How do you like that? There's something wrong with the radio.
Well, shake it.
Hit it. Kick it.
I will not. I can't understand it. The set has never gone bad before.
Oh, yes, it did, boss.
When?
During the Dempsey-Tunney fight.
Oh, yes. I remember.
Jack, here's the trouble. The plug is pulled out of the wall.
Well, plug it in. Plug it in.
Here comes the pitch. He swings and misses for strike 12.
Strike 12?
Wait a minute. DiMaggio called himself out. He's tired. The game is still tied at 1-1. Woodling is now on third. And coming up to bat is Charles Ezard.
You see, Mary? I told you. I told you.
The pitcher winds up. There comes the pitch. And now for a few words from our sponsor, Gillette.
Gillette?
Gillette, me tell you about Lucky Strike. Look sharp, feel sharp, be happy, go lucky. It's our custom to bring you famous athletes to say a few words about our product. Now, we'd like you to hear from four sportsmen.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me a package of Lucky Strikes. That's the cigarette everyone likes. So let's puff, puff, puff on a Lucky. Just remember the name. For it's one, two, three Lucky Strikes at the old ball game. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. The score for a Lucky is 2-1. Be happy, go lucky. You'll have so much fun if you pop, pop, pop on a Lucky. Just remember the name. For it's L-S-M-F-F-T at the old ball game.
Look sharp, feel sharp, be sharp.
Now Yogi Berra's at bat. The count is 1-1. Here comes the pitch, and it's a ball knee high. Here comes the windup, and the pitch, and it's ball three. That one was shoulder high. Here comes the windup again. And it's a strike right across the middle. It was...
Sally High.
Why doesn't she keep out of it?
That was strike two on Barra, and here comes the next pitch. What a wallop!
Sonny is down. Yes, he's down. And the referee is waving Dempsey to a neutral corner.
And that must have been stuck in there.
Shake it, boss. Shake it.
I am. There, I think it's fixed now.
The score is tied 1-1. Barra's on second, and Myers comes up to bat. It's a crucial moment. The pitcher is winding up, and he's ready to... Oh, boy, I'll have a hot dog. Thank you. The pitcher throws the ball. Myers hits the ball, and it's a long, long...
Run, 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 run!
What did he say? What did he say? Why didn't he put down that hot dog?
Yes, yes, it's going out to the
center of the
Stop eating already. Why doesn't he stop eating?
Well, that's the end of the night. And what's the game?
Oh, nuts. Turn it off, Rochester.
Kick it first. I want to see how that Dempsey Tunney fight came out.
Never mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, stop fires. Save jobs. Remember, the jobs as well as buildings go up in smoke. Fire destroys foodstuffs and materials we need to raise our production higher than ever before. Heed all fire regulations. Put out burning matches and cigarettes before discarding them. Thank you. Jack will be back in just a moment, but first...
Be happy, go lucky, be happy, go lucky strike, be happy, go lucky strike today.
Round, so firm, so fully packed, they're made without a flaw. That's why you find that Luckies are so easy on the draw.
I'll eat hot dogs or steak or fish, but only smoke one brand. Those milder, richer Lucky Strikes, the smoothest in the land.
Be happy, go lucky, be happy, go lucky strike. Be happy, go lucky strike today.
Yes, friends, be happy, go lucky. Enjoy your cigarette. For Luckies always give you perfect mildness. In fact, scientific tests confirmed by 3 independent consulting laboratories prove Lucky Strike is milder than any other principal brand. And together with mildness, you always get rich taste, too. All the deep-down smoking enjoyment that comes from truly fine tobacco. For LSMFT, Lucky Strike means fine tobacco. So, friends, be happy. Go lucky. Try a carton of Lucky Strike.
Be happy, go lucky, be happy, go lucky strike, be happy, go lucky strike today.
Well, there's nothing else on the radio, kids. Let's see what's on television. That's the trouble with television. You can see them, too. Well, I think I'll go outside and get the evening paper. Oh, darn it. The Colemans took it in already. Well, I'll cut across the yard and go back to the house. Oh, for heaven's sake, Remley, why don't you get up and go home?
Be sure to hear Dennis Day and the Day in the Life of Dennis Day. Stay tuned to the Amos Nandy Show. It follows immediately. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.